गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ पूनम बग्गा बैक अगेन विद चैप्टर 1 रैशनल नंबर्स. इन आर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड कम्प्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 1.1 एंड देन वी हैड डिस्कस्ड द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन. टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन एनी टू गिवन रैशनल नंबर्स. वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग दिस विद सम फ्यू सिंपल क्वेश्चंस इन्वॉल्विंग होल नंबर्स एंड इंटीजर्स. Here is the first one for you. How many whole numbers are there between 2 and 6? Very easy. Mark 2 and 6 on the number line and you can easily see that we are having 3 numbers in between 2 and 6. You can easily count them. They are countable or finite. Next, again we have one question. How many integers are there between -4 and 3? Again, let us mark them. This is -4 and this is 3. Let us find the numbers in between 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. What do you find? There are 6 integers in between, or we can say that they are countable. There are finite number of integers between any two integers. One more question we take. How many integers are there between -2 and -1? This is -2 and this is -1. Can you find any integer between them? Of course not. There is no such integer between -2 and -1 or between any two consecutive integers. But this is not the case with rational numbers. We cannot say that between -2 and -1 there don't lie any number. There lies many numbers and they are the rational numbers. How? Let us analyze that. How many rational numbers are there between 3/10 and 7/10? Locate them on the number line. 3/10 and 7/10. You will say on seeing this that there are 3 rational numbers between 3/10 and 7/10. But this is not the case. There are in fact many rational numbers between both these numbers. How? Let us see that. We can write 3/10 and 7/10 in this way. And then we can multiply by 10 in both numerator and denominator. Can we do this? Yes, of course we can do this. How? If we cancel 10/10, we will be left by 3/10. So, on multiplying any number both in numerator and denominator, the original value of the number does not change and therefore it is permissible. So, 3/10 and 10 into 10. This will give us 30/100 and this gives us 70/100. Now, what will you find? Can you write the numbers in between them? Yes, of course. 31/100, 32/100. 33/100, 34/100 and so on. And from here we will get 69/100, 68/100, 67/100 and so on in between. What do you find now? This 30/100 was actually the same number 3/10 originally, and this is also 7/10. Actually, so earlier when we were thinking that there are only 3 rational numbers between 3/10 and 7/10, now we are finding so many rational numbers in between these two numbers. And if you count them, they will come up to be 39 in number. There are 39 numbers between them in this way. You can count also, you will find it to be 39. And we can't stop here. Still many more rational numbers can be found between the same numbers 3/10 and 7/10. How? just multiply this 30 by 100 with yet another 100. Let us multiply one more 100 to these numbers. This will give us 30 into 100 upon 100 into 100, and this will give us 70 upon 100 into 100 into 100. What will we get? This will give us 3000 upon 10,000. This will give us 7000 upon 10,000. Now write the numbers in between. You will get 3001 upon 10,000, 3002 upon 10,000. Here you will get 6999 upon 10,000, 6998 upon 10,000, and the remaining numbers in between which I am not writing. Why? Because there are so many numbers. How much can I write? You can see. And originally this number is equal to 3 by 10 and this number is equal to 7 by 10. So now you see how many numbers are there between 3 by 10 and 7 by 10. If you count them, they come up to be 3999 numbers in between. And if we go on multiplying this number by another 10 or say 100, then you can't imagine how many numbers we will get in between the same two numbers, 3 by 10 and 7 by 10. So, in fact, in general, there are countless rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. So, originally, on seeing this number line, when we thought that there are only three rational numbers in between, now on seeing this picture, you see how many numbers are there, and still there can be many more. So always remember, there are countless or infinitely many rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. Clear? Now we will be doing some questions involving this discussion. Write any three rational numbers between minus 2 and 0. These are some examples from your book itself. Minus 2 and 0. Let us write minus 2 and 0. We can multiply by any number by both numerator and denominator. Take the denominator to be 1. Now, if I multiply by 10 to both the numbers, we will get 0 upon 10 here, minus 20 upon 10 here. Now you can easily write three rational numbers in between. Rational numbers in between are minus 19 upon 10, minus 18 upon 10, minus 17 upon 10. We have been asked 3, so I have written 3, otherwise there are many, many more. You can obviously see the line will go on, minus 16 upon 10, minus 15 upon 10 and so on. You can choose any 3 out of them. Theek hai? Clear? Now one thing more I want to say here is, one more method can be taken to find the rational numbers between minus 2 and 0. What is that method? That method is called mean method. What does this say? Let us visualize minus 2, minus 1 and 0 on the number line. Minus 2, minus 1 and 0. Now we need to find three rational numbers between minus 2 and minus and 0. So first number that we are able to see is minus 1. So the first number that we can write between minus 2 and 0 is minus 1. You can obviously see on this number line. The second number that we will find out lies between minus 2 and minus 1, between minus 2 and minus 1. How can we find this? Add both the numbers and divide by 2. Whenever there are two numbers A and B, we get the exact middle value of these two by dividing, by adding them and dividing by 2, and it lies in the middle of these two numbers. So, by adding minus 2 and minus 1 and dividing by 2, we will get the center number. This gives us minus 3 upon 2. This is the number minus 3 upon 2, this number. So, we have got two numbers. We need to find the third number also. Again, we can find the third number between minus 1 and 0. How? Add the two numbers and divide by 2. You will get the middle value of the two numbers. Minus 1 plus 0 upon 2. This will give us minus 1 upon 2. So, this is minus 1 upon 2. Now, we have got the three rational numbers between minus 2 and 0. So, rational numbers in between they are minus 3 by 2, minus 1 and minus 1 by 2 between minus 2 and 0. Once again we have a look, minus 2 and 0, they lie on the number line in this way, minus 2 or 0 number line par is tarah se hain. Inke beecho beech aapko ek rational number dikh raha hai jo ki minus 1 hai. To first number to ho gaya minus 1. Ab सेकेंड और थर्ड नंबर निकालने हैं, तो हम इन दोनों के बीच में माइनस टू और माइनस वन के बीच में एक नंबर ढूंढेंगे और एक नंबर माइनस वन और ज़ीरो के बीच में. कैसे ढूंढते हैं? दोनों को ऐड अप कर लीजिए और टू से डिवाइड कर लीजिए, तो आपको बिल्कुल सेंटर का बीच का नंबर मिल जाएगा. इसी तरह से माइनस वन और ज़ीरो को ऐड करने से सेंटर में माइनस वन बाय टू मिल गया हमें. ये इस तरह से माइनस टू और ज़ीरो के बीच में हमें तीन रैशनल नंबर्स प्राप्त हुए हैं. ठीक है, क्लियर? नेक्स्ट वी मूव ऑन टू अनदर क्वेश्चन. फाइंड एनी 10 रैशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन माइनस 5/6 एंड 5/8. नाउ वी नीड टू फाइंड द रैशनल नंबर्स. फॉर दिस द डिनोमिनेटर्स शुड बी सेम. वी नीड टू मेक द डिनोमिनेटर्स सेम. दे आर 6 एंड 8. टेक द एलसीएम ऑफ 6 एंड 8. LCM of 6 and 8, you will find it out to be 24. So, let us make the denominators 24, minus 5/6 and this is 5/8. To make it 24, we multiply by 4. If we are multiplying in the denominator, then we will have to multiply in the numerator as well. Again, to make it 24, we will multiply by 3. And then we will have to multiply the numerator also by 3. What we find? Minus 20 upon 24 and this is 15 upon 24. Now, can you find 10 rational numbers in between? Yes, of course. Now, the rational numbers in between they come out to be minus 19 upon 24, minus 18 upon 24, minus 17 upon 24, minus 16 upon 24, minus 15 upon 24, minus 14 upon 24, minus 13 by 24, minus 12 by 24. How many we have written? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Two more are required, minus 11 by 24 and minus 10 by 24. I have written them in continuous order. You may take randomly or in a continuous manner like this. So, we have taken 10 rational numbers between them. Let us revise how we did. First, look at the denominators. If they are different, make them same by taking the LCM. LCM comes out to be 24, so we made them 24. The denominators, we have made them same. Now we can easily find out rational numbers in between. We were asked 10 rational numbers, so we have written 10, and you are free to choose any 10 among them. Clear? Next, we have one more question. Find a rational number between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. A means only one rational number is to be found. So, one rational number, it is good to find it by mean method. So, we take out the mean. What does this method say? If we have two numbers A and B, to find the number in between, we will add them and divide by 2, so that it gets just in the center. So, we will add 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 and then divide by 2. This will give us 4 as the LCM, 4 ones are 4, so 1 ones are 1, 2 twos are 4, so 1 twos are 2, divided by 2. This will give us 3 by 4 divided by 2. This 2 can be written as 2 upon 1. Now, take the reciprocal of the second number, change this division by multiplication and take the reciprocal 1 by 2. This will give us 3 by 8. So, 3 by 8 is the number which lies between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Here we had to find only one number, so it is better to take it through a mean. Next we have, find 3 rational numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Again the numbers are same, but now we have to find 3 rational numbers. So, first let us make the denominators same. LCM of 4 and 2 comes out to be 4, so 1 by 4 will remain as such. 1 by 2 can be written in this way, multiply by 2 both in numerator and denominator, it gives us 1 by 4 and 2 by 4. Now, we can't find any rational number between them at this stage. So, we need to multiply by some number so that they become big enough to give us 3 rational numbers in between. अभी हम इनके बीच में कोई रैशनल नंबर नहीं ढूंढ पा रहे हैं 1/4 और 2/4 के बीच में, इसलिए हमें इसे किसी नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करके बड़ा करना होगा और फिर हम 3 क्या जितने नंबर उसमें हो पाएंगे हम उतने निकाल सकते हैं, उसमें से 3 हम सिलेक्ट कर लेंगे. किस नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करें ये भी हमारी चॉइस है. The number by which we should multiply, it depends on us. You can multiply by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, by 10, by 100. Whichever number you want, you can multiply. I am choosing 10. So, let us multiply by 10. This will give us 10 upon 40 and this will give us 20 upon 40. Now, you can easily write the rational numbers in between. Rational numbers. In between are 11/40, 12/40, 13/40, and there are many more. I have written 3 because 3 have been asked. You can select any 3 from them. Clear? One more thing I want to tell you is the mean method. There is one more method, the mean method. I would like to discuss that also with you, and then you can select your own method whichever you like. Mean method. Let us first mark 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 on the number line. This is 0 and let this be 1. So, 1 by 2 will lie somewhere here just in the middle of 0 and 1. And 1 by 4 will lie somewhere here. Now, we need to find 3 rational numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. we are using the mean method. So first number that we will get is add up both the numbers and divide by 2. How we find the mean? Add both the numbers and divide by 2. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 and divide by 2. In one of the previous questions we had done this. I am doing it again here for you all. 4 ones are 4, so 1 will come here. 2 twos are 4, so 1 twos are 2 divided by 2. This will give us 3 by 4 into 1 upon 2. This is 2 by 1 and division is changed into multiplication. This will give us 3 by 8. So the first number lying between them is 3 by 8 and where will it lie? Somewhere here, 3 by 8. Next we will find the second number between 1 by 4 and 3 by 8 again by finding their mean. Second number, how we find the mean? Add up the two numbers and divide by 2. The LCM will come out to be 8, 4 twos are 8, so 1 twos are 2 and 8 is same. So 3 will remain the same into 1 upon 2. This is 2 by 1 into 1 by 2 taking the reciprocal. This gives us 5 upon 16. So the second number is somewhere here 5 upon 16. Clear? Next we find the third number. How we will find it? Between 3 by 8 and 1 by 2. It will lie somewhere here and how we will find it? By finding their mean. And how we find the mean? Simply by adding and dividing by 2. Add both the numbers, 3 by 8 plus 1 by 2, add up and divide by 2. This will again give us the LCM 8, 8 ones are 8, so 3 ones are 3 plus 2 4s are 8, so 1 4s are 4 into 1 upon 2. This gives us 7 upon 16. This will lie here between 3 by 8 and 1 by 2, 7 upon 16. So the three rational numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 are, we can write somewhere here, 1 by 4, then we have 5 by 16. Then we have 3 by 8, then 7 by 16 and then last 1 by 2. So these are the three rational numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. We have done this question by two methods. One was this method, making the denominator same by multiplying and then we got the three numbers, and the second one is the mean method. It is up to you. Whichever method you like, you can do it by that method. There, don't think that the answers are different. We cannot say the answers will come up same, even between two children also. A may get some other answer and child B may get some other answer, because there are, don't forget, infinitely many rational numbers between two given rational numbers. So it does not mean, or don't expect, that the answers of two children may come up to be exactly same. They may vary. Okay. Now today we discussed the existence of infinitely many rational numbers between any two given rational numbers, and then accordingly we discussed a few examples from your book. In our next class we will be doing exercise 1.2 and then we will be completing this chapter. Till then, keep practicing, keep watching. Thank you.